Hi, I'm JJ Barnes and this is Jonathan McKinney.
Hello.
And you're watching another episode of Writing, Talking and Dog Walking. So today we're going to be talking to you about how to write a time lock.
So first of all, definitions. The time lock, we're talking about, you've established your story. You've established what your protagonist wants, your antagonist
you've
wants.
You've done your first act where you work all that stuff out.
You've fitted them against each other. They're locked in competition for the victory in your story, right? Whatever that might be. But there is sometimes a problem, which is that your characters, your protagonist and your antagonist can, if you don't manipulate the circumstances that they are forced into, they can
drift.
There can be a lack of haste, shall we say.
You need energy in your story. You need it to have the conflict and the excitement. And a time lock is the absolute brilliant way of doing this. Because a time lock is what tells both your characters and your audience that this is about to, you know, throw itself towards a climax.
Right, so sport movies tend to have a time lock because they're all building towards the big event.
The final competition.
The fight between Rocky and whoever, the rap battle between Eminem and whoever. I know that's not a sport movie,
but final dodgeball match.
The final dodgeball match, exactly. It's very bright.
It's horrible.
So sports movies are good for this, but movies or books that don't have, you know, a final event that you're building towards, you can find ways, creative ways, to put this pressure on your protagonist or your antagonist or both, by which they need to get something sorted within a certain time.
Yeah.
Right?
I've got one in Lily Prosper and the Magic Rabbit.
Right, okay. Do you want to describe that a little bit without spoilers, or will it be too spoilery?
Lily is working as like a trainee at an establishment, and he is about a final gathering, and she has to work out if that is a good thing or a bad thing, and she is under pressure then because things are building up and this final gathering is hurtling towards that, and she has to make decisions.
So in writing the 13 episodes of Grace Morris that we did last year, again, we're not going to give anything away at all about that, but the we used this device as well.
But the one we can talk about, which is genius, is season 5 of Buffy the Vampire Slayer, with Glory
is a god from a hell dimension, who comes to Earth and wants find her way back to Earth. In order to do that, she has to use a mystical key, which is turned into Buffy's little sister Dawn,
and they find out that the time and place where she can do this spell that will bleed all worlds together, so hell will reign on Earth,
very bad for everybody.
So obviously this is something they have to do something about, is hurtling towards them. As I say, it is coming, and that puts so much pressure on the characters.
The pressure goes on to Glory in this case, the bad guy, because she must get her job done before then, or she will fail. For the protagonists, it lets them off. If they can just essentially escape,
stop her,
and stop, well, not even stop her, just if they just
stop her finding Dawn,
prevent her from that way, if they can just stop her from finding this key, Dawn, and
the
then wait for the further time to pass, then she has failed.
She's failed. That's, because that time is coming, and they know that she is going to get more and more violent, more vicious in her quest to find this key. So they are under pressure to survive. They're under pressure to keep hiding. And Glory is under pressure to find the key and do this spell, or she is lost.
So you might say, in order to activate your protagonists a little better, that if they don't, if nothing happens, say, that the world will bleed and Glory will fail anyway, because then everybody's got better motivation.
See that. I don't like to criticize Buffy too much.
Well, you know, they're excellent storytellers, but you know, the choice they made was that, and it does end with Buffy and her friends essentially running away, which isn't great.
Well, it ends with Buffy dying.
Sure, big spoiler, but the point is, in the episodes preceding the finale, they run away, they get into a van and drive away. Not the best motivation for your protagonist, but the pressure it puts on the Glory is what we want to focus on.
The time lock is what is most motivating for her.
So when you're writing your story, if you're getting to the middle and you're like, I need to motivate these people, I need to make this more important.
Exactly. It makes the climax that you're building towards, something that everybody cares about and is actively preparing for or pursuing for a serious reason, because the worlds are going to bleed together or because the opportunity they've got is going to end, anything like that. The time lock makes your story then more intense.
Yes, it does. And certainly it's a way of raising the stakes.
Yeah, exactly, which is always good.
And making the stakes like all or nothing. So it's a good technique to use at the midpoint or at the end of your second act as you go into your third.
Yeah, I agree.
If your protagonist finds out that at the end of act two, if they do not succeed now, they can never succeed, then they have got extra motivation.
Which is why the sports movie would be the classic example, because it is literally, this is the match, and if you fail...
Yeah, the sports movie, though, tends to have the lock placed from the beginning.
Yeah, that is true.
Because you know when the big match is. It might be that you have an opportunity to play in a big match and it's all or nothing or whatever. Mm. But yeah, watch your sports movies for your lines of conflict, your time lock. Because we know when the big event is.
But don't
get locked into thinking that it's just got to be about a big event.
No, it just has to be something.
There's got to be a reason why, after a certain time, failure is the only option left.
Yeah.
And that's obviously not good enough for your protagonist.
So thank you very much for watching our video about time locks. We'll probably do other videos referencing other examples of it. We always say the more you see something, the more you understand it, the better you will be at using it yourself.
That's right. Yeah.
So this was our first video on time locks, essentially.
And we've used them.
As I say, I've used them.
Yeah.
It's good. It's effective. I am a big fan of a time lock.
Yeah.
I like feeling the tension of this is going to end and it's coming.
Yeah.
Because then you're like, you feel excited for the climax of the story.
Yeah, totally. And it can be meta as well. In Unholy Water, the time lock essentially is that you get to Halloween, it's a Halloween novel. You know that it's going to climax on Halloween. The characters don't really. So that might be something I could have done more tightly, but maybe it works on the meta level. So yeah, come and have a look anyway.
If you have ideas of good time lock examples and stories, drop a comment below and let us know, because if we can spot those too, then we can maybe do a video about them and talk about those.
Yeah.
That'd be awesome.
Ultimately, you want to snap the focus super sharp as you hurtle towards your ending, and that will help you do that.
If you could do us a massive favour and put the thumbs up little thing on this video and subscribe to our channel, you'll be able to help us keep making videos. You'll also get more on Hollowhood, our movie that we are going to be making.
Yeah.
So come check that out. And if you go to sirenstories.co.uk, you can find links to all our work, the books we've just referenced now, but I will be putting links into the description down below. So go check those out. And there's also loads of things over there that are happening. And we're on the Twitters. I'm Julianne Rose and he is John Muck.
I am.
And you can come talk to us about writing over there, because we're always hashtagging the writing stuff and everything that we're doing. So come find us and chat, and we'll retweet things that we get and everything like that.
Cool.
And it'll be great to talk to you. So thank you very much for watching, and we will talk to you again soon.
Bye.